A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 15th Jan. On the front page you have, after Modi's call, Trump likely to visit Delhi in late February. So US President Donald Trump will visit India, likely visit India in late February. The dates could be influenced, it is said, because of the impeachment process which is going on against US President Donald Trump. So, but he's likely to visit India. And this is, Supreme Court rejects curative pleas of two Nirbhaya death row convicts. So in the Nirbhaya gang rape case, we have seen the convicts have been sentenced to death and they have filed a curative petition in the Supreme Court, but these curative petitions have been rejected by the Supreme Court. So next appeal, they can go to the president for clemency, and if that is also rejected, they would be hanged. Then here you have, then below you have, hallmarking made must for gold jewelry. So now no jeweler will be allowed to sell gold jewelry or artifacts without hallmark from the Bureau of Indian Standards, BIS, from 15th Jan 2021 onwards. So if jewelers' artifacts made of 14 carat, 18 carat or 22 carat gold are sold without BIS hallmark, then the jeweler could be charged penalty 5 times the cost of the object or even given imprisonment up to 1 year. So gold hallmarking will be mandatory. That is the purity certificate. And it is presently voluntary in nature. Now it has been made mandatory. And this is, Kerala government challenges CAA in Supreme Court. So Kerala government has challenged the Citizenship Amendment Act. A suit has been filed under Article 131 of the Constitution. So state has approached the Supreme Court now nearly 15 days after the Assembly had unanimously requested the centre to abrogate the law on 31st December 2019. And 3 days earlier, we have seen Citizenship Amendment Act came into effect on Jan 10. And now an original suit has been filed before the Supreme Court. It's the original jurisdiction of the Supreme Court, that is when it is a dispute between states or between center and states. On page 8, you have planning body lists CRZ violations. So now fear of demolition of the houses is hanging over residents of Kozhikode, because the Department of Town and Country Planning has submitted the final list of CRZ violations in Kozhikode district in Kerala. And nearly 4,000 CRZ violations, including 1,657 within Kozhikode Corporation, 11 meters, have been identified. So, this, because we saw Marudu, here the four towers being brought down, and now other apartments also here are under fear of been demolished for CRZ violations, coastal regulatory zone violations. The rules are violated. And this is CRZ rules eased for blue flag beaches. So Environment Ministry has relaxed coastal regulation zone rules that restrict construction near beaches to help states construct infrastructure, enable them to receive blue flag certification. So the ministry selected 13 beaches in India to vie for the certificate. This is actually blue flag recognition is an international recognition on beaches, and they have to meet certain criteria of cleanliness and environment propriety. So the earmarked beaches here are in Gujarat, Maharashtra, Daman and Diu, Karnataka, Kerala, Tamil Nadu and Puducherry. So it is the Kappad beach in Kerala, Kovalam beach in Tamil Nadu, and even in Puducherry, Andhra Pradesh, Goa, Odisha. These are the Andaman and Nicobar Islands, Lakshadweep. These are the beaches recognized, first 13 beaches for which CRZ regulations would be relaxed. So the Blue Flag Beach is an ecotourism model and marks out beaches as providing tourists and beachgoers clean and hygienic bathing water, facilities, amenities, a safe and healthy environment and sustainable development of the area. So it is a program started by France in 1985 and has been implemented in Europe since 1987. And now it is moving outside Europe too since 2001. South Africa also joined in, and now India has also. Then below you have policy on rare diseases, another piece of paper. So activists have called it another piece of paper. This is National Policy on Rare Diseases 2020, which has been released recently by Union Health Ministry. It is called nothing more than an illusion because there is no clarity on long-term financial assistance which will be provided. So it is called a policy just on paper. The government has proposed the financial support of up to rupees 15 lakh under an umbrella scheme, Rashtriya Arogya Nidhi, for rare diseases. And these are for rare diseases that require one-time treatment. So that is it. So here you can see the beneficiaries for such financial assistance are only BPL families, below poverty line families, and 40% of the population becomes eligible as per the norms of Pradhan Mantri Jan Arogya Yojana. On the editorial page, the first editorial is theological thicket. So this is regarding the Supreme Court, 9-judge bench of the Supreme Court hearing on religious matters and how Supreme Court would deal with them. So it is trying to answer questions on these religious rights and how they have to be balanced with other fundamental rights. So Supreme Court must mark limits of religious freedom against which legality of practices can be tested. So how it will go through this and what the Supreme Court must do is discussed in this editorial. And this is inflation shocker. So this is regarding yesterday's front page news again. Inflation is at 7.35%. So the growth is sagging and prices are rising. So economy is entering in a very difficult phase now. The lead article is the long wait for empowered mayors. So mayors in many global cities go on to lead their country, but in India it is the opposite story, and politics is to be blamed for that because mayors are not empowered. They are not having powers with them that they can take action and improvise the city, work for the welfare of the city. And this is chalk and cheese in private and versus government schools. So the annual status of education report findings make clear case for strengthening early childhood education centers. So this is a point being made. So education of children and school readiness is important. So early childhood education is emphasized on. Then on OPED page you have, this is an article on government running out of tricks and in the context of protests which we are seeing too. And here you have a regime that chooses its critics. So it talks about how NGOs work is being curbed by invoking FCRA, Foreign Contribution Regulation Act. So this is a troubling matter. So that is detailed out. It's very important. And this is the risk of a domino effect. So this is regarding how US-Iran conflict can make Iraq the battleground and will affect neighboring countries, Syria and Lebanon too. So how this international conflict should be resolved presently is important, is discussed. On page 12, you have ASER flags poor learning outcomes in rural schools. So this is the annual status of education report 2019, which has been released by an NGO, Pratham. So it says only 16% of children in class 1 in 26 surveyed rural districts can read text at the prescribed level. And almost 40% cannot even recognize letters. So this is poor outcomes, learning outcomes in rural schools, which has been found. On international page, you have Iran nuclear deal. EU launches dispute mechanism. So Britain, France and Germany have charged Tehran over transgression that could ultimately lead to reimposition of UN sanctions too. Because Iran has stated that it would not follow the Iran nuclear deal. And since it has started violations, the USA has opted out of the nuclear deal, but European countries are still members and they have said for such transgressions by Iran, they would reimpose UN. There would be ultimately reimposition of UN sanctions too. And this is severe weather kills 130 in Pakistan, Afghanistan. So here you can see severe weather conditions have resulted in this heavy snowfall resulted in people being stranded and even 130 killed. Then this is on business page, Jio UVARC emerged top bidders for Reliance Communication. So Reliance Communication of Anil Ambani is being sold off and bids have come of about 25,000 crore for its assets, with Reliance Jio placing a bid of 4,700 crore for its mobile tower and fiber assets. And both together have agreed to pay 7,500 crore or 30% of the total proceeds within 3 months. Then this is wholesale inflation rises 2.59% in December. So the retail inflation, CPI we saw, and now this is WPI figures also, which are at an 8-month high. So that is it. These are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website aashara.com. Thank you.